Hello, hello, welcome everybody, dear friends, colleagues, and professionals. Here we are today, in this Sunday, we're gonna talk about a big issues now. We call it VUCA in supply chain. Well, some of us maybe already know what VUCA is, but I really do want to know what VUCA is and what its effect to our companies and our surroundings. And tonight, we're gonna make this webinar a little different because this is a big day for us because we have Pak Tefrata Denny as our speaker, and we're gonna have a relaxed conversation, not too formal, and then we're gonna have things through a little bit different. So we're gonna have a relaxing environment. So after tonight, we welcome you to prepare yourself for participation, for your comment, and for your question, because we're gonna have a fun tonight talking about VUCA in supply chain. So please welcome our speaker now, Mr. Tefrata Denny.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Tefrata. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
Okay, I'm fine. You look fresh. Have you bathed yet?
Yeah, I look fresh because I'm not become a host tonight. Yeah, so we swap.
Yeah. This is quite surprising for me because somebody just asked me to be a host just the other day, and then I have to be prepared for everything. So, thank you for the assignment. So, today we're going to talk about VUCA, right, Pak?
Yes, yeah, indeed, yeah, VUCA. Yeah. Do you know what is VUCA is?
That's what I'm talking, what I'm thinking the last 2 days. Because I believe that VUCA means a little bit like ice cream, yeah?
Okay, ice cream. What kind of ice cream is it?
I think it's the V, vegetable.
Oh, okay. So V is a vegetable?
Vegetable,
and then?
Right. U, it's a unique.
Okay, unique.
It's a unique.
Okay.
And then the C is... Oh, sorry. The U, I think it's under, and the C is cherry.
Okay, and then A.
So the ice cream cherry, and then the A is apricot. So
okay.
You put it together, VUCA is vegetables under cherry and apple and apricot.
Okay, vegetable under cherry and apricot. Yeah, so that's a VUCA in the ice cream industry.
Yeah.
Okay. How about if you talk about VUCA in automotive industry? What do you think?
I think VUCA is the V, maybe vehicle.
Vehicle.
And you maybe still under, yeah?
Under.
I like the under, maybe.
Okay.
Because, you know, under means under.
Hmm?
And then the C means car.
Okay. Yeah.
And then the A means available. So, yeah, vehicle under car is available. It's like the A team, you know,
the A team
when you got
the movie,
another vehicle in the car just pops out from the back of the van.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I think it's good. Yeah, vehicle under car available. So yeah. The motorcycle can get out from the car because it's inside the car itself, yeah? Yeah, so that's a VUCA in the automotive industry. Yeah, very good.
Yeah. So, for our viewer, please help me to define maybe in one word what is VUCA in your experience or in your thinking. Please openmenti.com. And then use code 715200. Please open menti.com and use the code 715200. Well, we'll be waiting. And then, Pak Tefrata.
Yes, yeah.
Okay, we're talking about
COVID-19.
Oh, COVID-19.
Yeah, it's
Wow.
relevant, I think. Yeah, VUCA is.
VUCA and COVID-19, right. In the sense of also there's also VUCA in hospital.
Yeah, maybe it's
In
something like that, yeah.
veterinary. Yeah.
Okay, volatile, pandemic. Okay, yeah, good. Yeah. Yeah, because you already give a little bit clue, yeah. Maybe some of us quite shy because the answer already answered by you, yeah, Pak Krisnov.
Okay. Maybe because I know that I don't know what
okay.
Bukan. So yeah. So I just spread it out. It was
okay. And then
right.
Headaches. Okay.
Headaches.
Yeah. Isn't it? Agile, yeah, I like that word. Yeah, dynamic. Yeah.
Maybe we explain one by one, yeah, these words. Maybe if it's connected or not.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Volatile.
Okay, let's talk about.
Volatile.
Okay, uncertainty. There's a bigger percentage. Many people said uncertainty.
Yes, uncertainty.
Complexity. Maybe you can explain, Pak, uncertainty.
Before I explain, maybe we can use your terminology, yeah, like VUCA in ice cream industry, which is a vegetable, yeah. But I'm surprised, yeah, nobody said vegetable in here. Like cherry, yeah, cherry and apricot. Why nobody say cherry or apricot in here? I'm quite surprised as well. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but yeah, don't worry. We will discuss what is the real VUCA. Yeah, maybe this is a prologue from Pak Krisnov, and yeah, we will discuss the real one. But now, please just join. Yeah, as the Pak Krisnov mentioned, you can write down what do you think about VUCA. Don't be shy. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So there's ambiguity, dynamic, awareness, influence.
Oh yeah. Nice.
Influence, like influenza, influence.
So it's like a pandemic as well?
A pandemic, oh yeah. Okay, and then what is threat? Okay. Changes, right. Costly, wow. Okay. Okay, Pak, can we explain what the our viewers said about VUCA?
Yeah. Yeah, like uncertainty is a very big word, yeah. Maybe more than one or two people already said about the uncertainty, and volatile, yeah, volatile or volatility, yeah, is a good as well. Yeah? Complexity, dynamic, okay, dynamic is a good one as well. So the moment right now is always dynamic, ambiguous. Then costly, VUCA is costly, yeah. Yeah, although I think we don't have to pay for VUCA, but yes, sometimes it's costly. Yeah, can you buy VUCA in like an ice cream?
Maybe if I make ice cream, I'm going to tell.
Yeah, maybe yeah for Pak Krisnov, yes, we can buy VUCA, I think.
Yeah.
Because it's a ice cream industry.
Yeah, well, yeah. If it's uncertainty, then when people try it, maybe sometimes it's sour, sometimes it salty.
Salty.
Sometimes hot, like that maybe.
Volcano. Oh, yeah, it's good. Volcano.
Yeah. V. I think it's V.
Okay, and
lion.
Disruption. Competitor intelligence. Okay, tricky. Yeah, VUCA, tricky, yeah, okay, and then volatility, uncertainty, I think it's not finished yet, but remember it's a one word, yeah, and then strategic alliance, wow, quite surprised, a lot of people, friends join us tonight, yeah, maybe because they don't agree with you about VUCA in automotive industry, which is the
yes,
what is it, vehicle
yeah.
under car available,
vehicle under car available, right? Maybe the car give birth to another car or another vehicle underneath. You know when the there's a I think a apa remote control car in the James Bond movie. Wait, there's Suka under there. What do you mean? There's a vehicle under your car. Wow.
Okay. So James Bond also said Fuka in the movie.
Yeah.
I don't remember that. Wait, Fuka under your car? Okay.
Okay. Oh, if somebody says camouflage.
Yeah. So, okay. Yeah, it's very good.
Agile. Okay, competitor camouflage awareness, uncertain threat rate influence, interdependence. Okay, proliferation. Okay. Okay. So, what do you think, Pak? Which one is the best word? I think, maybe.
I just follow the word in here. The best maybe uncertainty because most of people say it about uncertainty. And then number two, I think volatile, yes. And then the third is complexity. The fourth is dynamic, So we have four big words in here. I think I agree, with the audience for tonight. So
but
uncertainty.
It's kind of strange, but because there's a V, volatile, and then U, uncertainty, and the C, complexity. But where's the A? This is the dynamic. This is
E,
not A.
I think it's not dynamic. It's dynamic. Yeah, dynamic. So it's a Fuka.
Right.
Yeah, but we will discuss what is the Fuka, the real Fuka, after this. It's in my slide. So I have to look at my slide because I don't remember what is Fuka, to be honest.
It's just because maybe you're very stingy.
Okay, ambiguity become big, it's getting bigger. Oh, so you have your A, Pak Krisnov. Yeah, I think
this is the real one, the real A.
The real A. Oh, but previously you said A is apricot, not ambiguity.
Yeah. And don't forget available.
Okay, apricot and available.
If I think that I want to make ice cream, I'm going to make it available with apricot. Right.
Okay, so do you want to start?
Okay, Ma. We have a lot of comments here and this is a lot of participation. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, friends and professionals for giving us these one words. And we really appreciate your participation here. So, I'm wondering what Fuka is and what its connection with supply chain, and this is Pak Dennis' moment to explain to me and to all of us what is Fuka in supply chain. Please, the time is yours, Pak Denny.
Okay, thank you, Pak Krisnov. Do you want to swap role now? Because I see in here, I'm a speaker tonight,
I prefer to be a host, Pak.
Okay.
Because speaker have to make a presentation and talking about something that I don't know, it makes me kind of chill.
Okay, Pak Krisnov, thank you, Pak. So we will start to discuss what is Fuka is, and thank you again for the introduction. And friends, please relax and join our discussion today.
Yes,
and again,
enjoy.
Why don't you tell them they can ask the questions?
Okay. So that's why this is sopir tembak Pak, atau nyos tembak namanya. I forgot that for all of you, our viewers, friends and professionals, please you can ask us by using the YouTube chat section. You can ask in English or in Indonesian. We will gladly translate and we will gladly answer any of your question, but regarding these topics, not personal question like what I'm wearing now or what underwear we're wearing now. So
why don't you stand up? Usually people during this online session, they only wear a good shirt up there, but we don't know what is under.
That's why I talk about under a lot, because you and me, we know that we're not wearing
What?
proper under.
We are so far now, yeah, not too okay. close. Like,
yeah. We should use masker if you're close by.
Yeah,
so because
enough.
We are too far, then it's okay for us. Okay, Pak.
Okay.
Without further ado, please present your thingy.
Okay, thank you, Pak Krisnov, and then friends, so we can talk now, yeah, about VUCA, and then we will have a discussion about VUCA in supply chain. And again, please allow me to introduce myself. I'm Efrata, and I got three certification titles from IACEA, which is the first is CSCA, Certified Supply Chain Analyst. The second is CSCM, Certified Supply Chain Manager, and then the third is CDDP, Certified Demand Driven Planner. And in Indonesia, I am the first people who got the certification in CDDP, Certified Demand Driven Planner. We can discuss more about that, but tonight, yeah, we will discuss about what is VUCA and what about VUCA in supply chain. Yeah, regarding that, so we can have more discussion. Okay, VUCA in supply chain. Yeah, before we talk about VUCA in supply chain, so we need to know what is VUCA first. Yeah, previously our host already mentioned VUCA in ice cream industry and then VUCA in the automotive industry, but yeah, why not we talk about what is the VUCA is. Yeah, and this is the picture. Yeah, I want to start with this picture. If you very interesting with an art, I think some of you already know about this picture. And then the picture show something that is quite annoying, yeah, because when you see there's a lot of stairs in here, but if you see again closely, something wrong in this picture. That's why I'm telling that something that is annoying. And then as you can see in here, the title of this picture is Relativity. Yeah, it was painted by Maurits Cornelis Escher, and he is the Dutch graphic artist. Yeah, this is in 1953, and then talking about relativity. And then one quote from him is, "Are you really sure that a floor can also be a ceiling?" So yeah, sometimes it's a relative. Yeah, you can say that that is a floor. Yeah, but maybe from someone they can say that is not a floor, that is a ceiling. Yeah, so it's a relative. Yeah, yeah, that's why we can see from this picture as well, it's a relativity. Yeah, something that is a relative. And then one quote from him as well, he said that, "I think it's in my basement. Let me go upstairs and check." Can you see what is something wrong in this statement? Okay, yeah, I believe you already noticed it. Yeah. And then prologue to the VUCA as well. Sometimes if we see or we hear somebody tell to us, it is already certain. Yeah, it is already certain. In this situation, yeah, maybe in current situation, if something is already certain, it means it's already uncertain itself. So if it's already certain, then it means it is uncertain. Yeah, that is a prologue to VUCA. And based on this picture, you can see all things is relative. Yeah, and then what happened right now? I will tell you what is VUCA is. Yeah, so VUCA is acronyms VUCA, and then VUCA have terminology of V for volatility, and then U is uncertainty, and then C is complexity, and A is ambiguity. Actually, this terminology was coming from the military part, yeah, especially from US in the North America. And then they want to describe what is the situation they already facing in 1990s. So especially in the Middle East, when we have a condition, and then they want to describe what is the condition, so they have a terminology of VUCA. So that is the background of the VUCA itself. So the same words in here, And then now, and most people in the business, in the industry, in the company, they use the same terminology as well. But some of us, and then some of the company, they just mention VUCA as a one word, yeah. So VUCA. But actually, there are several tools mention that VUCA actually is not one word, yeah, not VUCA. But they are separated in the quadrants. So if we mention about quadrant, so there is a quadrant of V, quadrant of U, quadrant of C, and then quadrant of A. So they will have a situation in each quadrant. So not a one word, because sometimes we heard that we have a VUCA situation, yeah. But there are tools as well we can discuss tonight, which is there is a quadrant, and then we can separate each of box in the quadrant. And then let's see, yeah. What is volatility? Volatility is the quality of being subject to frequent, rapid, and significant change. And then to describe about volatility, we can see about the competition, yeah. The competition, how about the competitive being a global. Sometimes we already feeling nice running our business, nobody come to us, and then we already become market leaders, yeah. But when the globalization comes from outside of our country, they comes to our market, and then the competitive began, yeah. Competition began. So the situation become volatile. This is how we describe about the volatility. And then the volatility indicates the business environment is turning to be more chaotic and unpredictable in speed and volume, yeah. One practical solution is to reconciling volatility is with vision. So if you want to reconcile the volatility, then prepare with your vision in the sense of looking far ahead and focusing on what is the goal. When the project reality continues to change due to collisions with the latest situation in the field, the vision will ensure that the direction of project development remains in line with the direction of the company. The project leaders must stick to the goals and target that have been set because of the vision again, yeah. So although we face the volatility, we have to make sure that the project produce the result as planned no matter what happens in the process. It operates, the leader must focus on one activity that can be closer to one person. The best way is to distinguish between important activities and closeness, ideas that come from distraction and always think about the big picture. So basically that's about the volatility. And how about the uncertainty? Uncertainty is a characteristic of that situation in which event and outcomes are unpredictable. So we talking about unclear in vision, unclear in planning. It's hard to do the, yeah, if we talking about current situation, it's hard to do the forecasting, yeah. It's hard to do planning. And then the uncertainty refers to an environment that offers little information for making big decisions. The most possible way to deal with uncertainty is understanding by using the latest data as a reference. To reduce uncertainty, project leaders must be willing to disclose accurate and up-to-date data revealed to the project being handled. But how can you make important decision if you have to rely on old data? Always remember, project management today different from 20 years ago. Current management project leaders can take advantage on the latest tools that are able to quickly analyze situation so as to quickly make the decision making process. So in the uncertainty, we know that the situation will be uncertain, yeah, of course. And then complexity, yeah. Complexity involves a multiplicity of issue and factors, some of which may be intricately interconnected. Yeah. Complexity can comes in the industry or community. For example, if you see a company right now, maybe, yeah, for example, telecommunication. Yeah, we have a telecommunication company, the big one, Telkom Indonesia. Yeah, do you know what is the core business of Telkom Indonesia? Are they selling fixed phone? Are they what are they selling? Yeah, you can see that they are selling everything. Yeah, they can sell a movie, they can sell phone, they can sell many things, education as well. Yeah, so it's become a complexity because of the industry become unclear right now. If you mention about another company, maybe like a newspaper company, yeah, in Indonesia we have Kompas, you know. Can you mention what is the industry right now about Kompas? Is it a media industry only? Actually no, yeah, because they also have a hotel. They have a hotel, so not only the media. So it's like the industry is become quite complex right now. So it drives the complexity. Yeah? So a lot of issue and factors in there. And then the complexity indicates that the environment is very dynamic with many relationship that make it difficult to break down, to untangle the tangled threads due to complexity, namely through clarity. So the way you want to fix the complexity is you have to have the clarity, or it can be interpreted as simple and clear communication, so that is easily conveyed. In today's complex world environment, communication is an important skill that individuals involved in project management must possess. According to Albert Durick, communication is a source of synchronization between individuals in one project. So project leader must be able to explain what the members involved and then what they should do. With a clear attitude, workers will know their roles and responsibility and are better able to understand what's wrong if things don't go according to plan. So that is about the complexity. And let's discuss about the ambiguity, the last one. Yeah? So ambiguity is manifested in a lack of clarity and the difficulty of understanding exactly what the situation is. So if we want to describe it in one word, ambiguity, it is similar with the gray area. Yeah? Gray area, maybe it's not black, it's not white. Yeah. Maybe also we can talk about the multi-perception regulation. There is a regulation, already tell about this, but there is a maybe. Maybe, yeah. So it's like a gray area in the regulation as well. Yeah. So this is about the ambiguity. Yeah. So in ambiguity can means that the business environment cannot be explained because the information obtained can be interpreted in various ways. There's nothing like fighting ambiguity with agility, which provide the flexibility to adjust for changes as quick as possible. So this situation become unexplained, the project leader must have a flexibility in an effort to respond the change quickly. So agility, yeah, again, agility or dexterity will impact on being proactive rather than reactive, which can help provide alternative strategies. So that is talking about the VUCA, and then we know that the terminology is volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. And again, as I mentioned before, it is not only in one sentences. Yeah, actually, some people also make it become a quadrant. So let's us discuss about the quadrant. This is the quadrant. You can see in here, in the quadrant, we have volatility. On the top right in here, and then we also have this is a volatility, and then we have uncertainty, and then we have complexity in here, and then we also have ambiguity on the bottom left. Yeah, and then what it mean, we can see on the left here, how well can you predict the outcome of your action. So if you can predict the outcome, yeah, the predict is a big capital in here. If you can predict, then you are in the plus area, yeah, in the top. But if you cannot predict what is the outcome of your action, then you are in the bottom, yeah, in the minus in here. And then you can see the bottom arrow. So it state that how much do you know about the situation. If you know about the situation, then you are in the right quadrant, yeah. But if you don't know about the situation, then you are on the left quadrant. So for example, yeah, for example, you know that one of the big taxi company in Indonesia, Bluebird, yeah, Bluebird. So if we ask them about the prediction when the online driver, online taxi come to Indonesia, do you know about it? Can you predict about it? Yeah. Do you know that the technology will come? They can say yes. We already prepared. We have application already, yeah, Bluebird application in mobile phone, yeah. So it mean they can predict about the technology will come. So they already prepared. So we can say that they are in the top quadrant in here. They already predicted. And then if we ask them, do you know about the situation? If the online taxi will come, do you know about the situation? Yes, we know about the situation. So that's why we already invest on the technology. So they are in the volatility, yeah. But what happened in the volatility? So they already know it will happen, but they are not prepared good enough, yeah. They already, yeah, we can say they already prepared, but not good enough. So when the competitors come in a different way, different doing of the business using application, basically they don't have asset of a car, something like that, yeah, because it's based on the application, right? So different with the taxi company, so the situation become volatile, yeah. So it's like yeah, they don't agree, and then they don't want to accept what happened, yeah. Actually they already know that yeah, the prediction, they already know the prediction it will come, but they don't know when it will come. So that is the example of volatility, yeah. If you want to use this quadrant as well, yeah, like a bombing in Beirut, yeah, if you want to using in here, how about the situation there? Does the government already know that it will happen there? I think, yeah, no, they don't know. They cannot predict what the accident will happen. Yeah, so it's mean in the below quadrant in here. And then, do you know that the government know about the situation in there? Is it a good situation or not good situation? According to the news, that before the accident happen, there are a lot of, I mean, not a lot, but some missile come, yeah. Some missile come because they have not good, situation in the country. That's why when the accident happens, there are a lot of news. Yeah, a lot of news, and then blaming another countries because before missile is coming, yeah, but not giving a big impact, yeah. That's why they know about the situation. So if we using this quadrant, they know the situation, maybe it will happen like a bombing like that, yeah. And then if we say that, do they predict it? No, they cannot predict it, yeah. So they are in the uncertainty area, yeah. That's why if you see the news now, the government investigate whether the bombing in the Beirut is coming from the missile, yeah. So it is in the uncertainty part in here. So you can use, yeah, practice using this quadrant, what happens with the supply chain as well, yeah. So if something accident like a bombing like that, of course the supply chain will be impacted. And then, yeah, later we will discuss how we implement the strategy if we facing in each of the quadrant in here. So you have to remember, yeah, volatility is in the top right, and then the uncertainty is on the bottom right, and then C, the complexity is in the top left, and then the ambiguity is in the bottom left. Okay, If we talking about the terminology in here, it's mean VUCA, we only look at as a threat, yeah? Because every words in here is like a threat for our company, for ourselves. So volatility is a threat, yeah? Uncertainty, also a threat. Complexity, ambiguity, all of them is a threat for us. But if you want to look at the VUCA not as a threat, then you can look at it as an opportunity. So this is how you look at the VUCA as a opportunity. So you moving from threat becomes opportunity. So volatility becomes visibility, yeah? Visibility, and then uncertainty becomes unconstrained, and then complexity become connected, and then ambiguity become artificial intelligence or AI. There is the way of views changing our threat become opportunity. And then this is the explanation about the visibility. It means you will have an agile and then proactive decision making. So if you talking about the supply chain, then you will have a visibility along your supply chain with your customers, with your suppliers, so you can become more agile, yeah, and then have a proactive decision making, of course. So if you talking about the unconstrained, it means unlimited possibilities of technology and customer experience. Yeah, you can see in here, yeah. Then if you talking about the supply chain as well, sometimes we have constraint, yeah, a lot of constraint. But if you looking at the opportunity, it means there are a demand in the market, although you have a constraint of capacity, yeah. So it means you can unlock yourself, become the unlimited possibility of technology. You can adopt a new technology, and then you can give a new customer experience. And then how about the connected, yeah? Connected means close collaboration with internal and external partners. So in the supply chain as well, you can improve the close collaboration, yeah, with internal and then also the external partners. And then the AI. AI means automate non-value add activities and deep analytics. So that is how you change the threat become opportunity. But what is the real strategy if you want to implement the VUCA, this opportunity in the supply chain? So this is the quadrant as well. You can have a look. You can use it as well in your company. So on the left in here, you will have a demand predictability. Yeah, demand predictability usually measured by CV, coefficient of variation. Coefficient of variation can be divided into below 0.5 and then above 0.5. So if the coefficient of variability is above 0.5, it means you have a high demand variability in the above quadrant in here. So CV above 0.5. And if the CV or coefficient variation below 0.5, it means you have a low demand variability. Yeah. So you already can divide the demand variability in here. And then the next is we will have a supply volume. So supply volume can be used by several ways, yeah. The first, maybe you can use a Pareto. Pareto means 80-20, because sometimes if the supply volume 20% is already have 80% of value, yeah. So we can have 20 in here and then 80 in here, so we can have 80 supply volume and then 20 supply volume in here. So you can do a Pareto. And then the second way, you can use also an ADI, average demand interval. So average demand interval means you will look at your data and then you see the demand interval, and then you will have for example the number there according to your data. Usually, for example, if you have like let's say 1.5 ADI, it means above 1.5 you will have a high supply volume, and then below 1.5 you will have low supply volume. And then if you already exercise this ADI and CV, so most people say ADI, so ADCV, you can have a 4 quadrants, right? So you can have in here on the V, you will have a lumpy demand. We can say it's a lumpy demand. And then in the second, yeah, in here, in the, you can say this is intermittent demand. So lumpy demand is on the red, and then on the orange in here is intermittent demand, and then on the green in here we can say it erratic demand, and then on the bottom left in here we can say it is a slow moving demand. So you already have a calculation, and then you just implement the strategy. So the strategy basically can divide it into two in supply chain. The first one is responsive strategy, and then the second is efficient strategy. So you can see in the above in here, we can have a responsive strategy of the supply chain. And then the below, the bottom in here, we can have an efficient supply chain strategy. And then you can see if we have in the V quadrant, you remember the red means V, right? Volatility, yeah. So we can do the assemble to order products strategy, yeah. And then for the U quadrant in here, you can have a strategy of efficient supply chain, and then you can do the production strategy of make to stock product. So in the C quadrant, on the green one in here, you can have a responsive supply chain with the make to order product strategy. And then in here, you can see in the bottom left, in the A quadrant, you can have a strategy of efficient supply chain and make to stock products. So that's how you calculate, and then how you can divide your situation, what is in the real company, yeah, based on your data, of course. Then you can use maybe the ADI and CV, and then you can divide the supply volume, and then the demand predictability, and then you can use the correct strategy in your company. Okay, and then some of people also mention that if you talk about VUCA, then you need to have the cure, yeah, the cure, especially in the leadership. So this is the cure in the leadership, yeah. So if you want to look at the volatility, then the cure is with the vision, yeah. So the leader must have a vision. What is a vision? Vision can keep the big picture in minds all the time, yeah. Know what your vision is and work towards it. It means you can give a correct vision, and then make the company become have a good vision. Yeah. And then the second is uncertainty. We can use understanding. Yeah. So the leader have to understand what is the situation, and then can we say like do what they said, yeah, walk the talk, and then the understanding also create security for people so that they can get on with their job. So the understanding also can means we break down the task, so we know that what happened with our team. So that is the understanding. So the uncertainty become certain if we do leadership with the understanding way. And then the third is complexity. So the cure of complexity is with clarity. So you can create a clarity and focus, and then accept what you do not do and make clear decision based on the information. So if we say the clarity, it means you have a good SOP, the standard operating procedures, and then also we can have a clear programs, or we can have a clear concept, yeah, like that. So that's mean clarity, yeah? So although there are a complexity, then we can have the cure with the clarity. And then the ambiguity, yeah, we can do the leadership cure for the ambiguity is agile, eh? Agility. So in agility, agility is mean we will have a resilience, yeah, resilience, and then we can manage all, we involve people, We communicate as openly as you can and then get feedbacks from others. So with the agility, it mean we can have a more resilience. That's a strong word, yeah. So with the resilience, then you can manage the company, you involve and communicate with the people. So that is the cure for the ambiguity. Yeah, I think that's a lot we already discussed tonight. Yeah, so if you have any questions, then we can do the discussion. And thank you again from the Enabling Supply Chain Management. And then also thank you for not making me become a host and become a speaker. So now I think we can do the discussion. Yeah, thank you, Pak Krisnov. That is the explanation from me.
Efrata, thank you for your time, information, and did my face look clear enough, Pak, di situ?
Yes, of course.
Okay, because I cannot see here because maybe I didn't take a bath today.
I don't know what is the correlation, yeah, between fuka and then taking a bath.
Because it's So, Pak. Let me ask you some of the question first, yeah. Because I'm the host, I have the first question maybe.
Usually the questions came from the participant, not from the host. But yeah, it's okay. Yeah? It's okay, but.
Okay. I just wondering why business always takes some stuff from military, like Sun Tzu with their art of war, and then this is the war things, right? Fuka from military of American military. What about other things? Why? But still, it's in the 90s. It's not the 2000s. Why they took a lot of time to be implemented in businesses?
Okay, yeah, from the military. Yeah, some of friends also mentioned to me. Yeah, if you want to be a good strategist people, you want to implement a good strategy, then go to cinema and watch a war movie. That's why sometimes if you have time, yeah, you can see that in the movie there are a lot of strategy, different strategy how to compete in the battlefield, something like that. So in the war movie, we can see that how a great leaders can implement their strategy. They can do a maneuvers, yeah, and then. Yeah, most of the strategy then can be implemented in the business as well, yeah, because business sometimes we can call it like a competition field, yeah, but of course, yeah, we cannot say that the competitors is our enemy. Yeah, but they are our competitors, but of course we have to adopt some kind of strategy to do in our business. That's why we can say it a competitive advantage, yeah, Pak.
Okay,
I think that's the answer from me.
Okay, thank you, Pak. Maybe you could buy me some tickets for the movies, maybe, because you're advising me for that.
Go to the movie with me, okay? As long as you wearing a skirt, yeah, Pak. Then we can go to the movie together. Yeah?
Okay, question here. Let's look our question here. Oh no. First, Pak Fajar, okay, good evening to Pak, Bu Kartika Sari, hello. And then Pak Ignas, good evening. Pak Abi, okay, selamat malam juga Pak. Pak Wahyu, okay, Pak, selamat malam. Pak Suryo, selamat malam Pak. Bu Kaira, okay, good evening. Bu Mia, and Pak Franz, selamat malam juga Pak. Yeah, okay, this is the first question, ya Pak, from Pak Fajar. Pak Denny, yeah. Refer to the metrics table shown, demand predictability versus supply volume. Do you think FUKA has a very close relation with bullwhip effect in supply chain? Kindly elaborate on how to mitigate.
Okay, yeah, that's a very good question. Thank you for the question, Pak Fajar. So if we look at here again, yeah, how we can see the situation in here. Let me explain it again. So near Pak Krisnov, there is a demand predictability arrow, yeah. on the from the bottom to the top, and then near me it's a supply volume arrow. So if we mention about the bullwhip effect, so it's mean the bullwhip effect, we have to ask first, yeah. Can we predict the demand, yeah, Pak Fajar? If you can predict the demand, then you are in the above quadrant, which is in here, yeah, in the above in here, because you can predict the demand. And then if we can ask ourselves again, can we predict the demand? No, we cannot. So we are in the bottom in here. Basically, something like that. If we want to exercise in with words, yeah, do you can predict the demand or not? So bullwhip effect sometimes happens like that, yeah. If we cannot do the prediction, then it will happens and then it become bigger and bigger about the bullwhip effect. But in mathematical, if you want to do with the calculation, yeah, in mathematic ways, you can use the coefficient of variation. Again, as I mentioned before, if the CV is above 0.5, then you are in the high, and if the CV is below 0.5, it means you are in the low demand variability. So, and then for the supply volume, yeah, for the supply volume, in the bullwhip effect, we can see that if the whip become bigger, then the supply volume will become high as well. Yeah? If the whip is become low, so we are in the low supply volume as well. So using this quadrant, we can adopt it to be a strategy how to face the bullwhip effect. So for example, for the supply volume is high and then the demand predictability is low, so it mean we cannot predict the demand, right? So it mean better we do the make to stock, make sure our stock in our warehouse, the inventory in our warehouse is available. So we use the efficient supply chain in here, but we are using the make to stock strategy. So this is a strategy we can adopt to face the bullwhip effect. And then for example, if we having a high supply volume but the demand predictability is high, so we can predict the demand. So it means we don't have to do the make to stock strategy, then we can have assemble to order product, yeah. And then if we have like a supply volume is low, then we can think about the demand prediction. If the demand predictability is high, it means we can do the make to order product. So we don't have to put a lot of stock in our warehouse because we are doing the make to order strategy, yeah, in the top left diagram. That's how you use the matrix again, Pak Fajar. So it means I hope you can exercise this, and then if you have hard to calculate the CV, coefficient of variation, I think we can do like giving a workshop in our study group, or we can discuss it in our study group as well. I think Pak Krisnov will say that if all of you interesting to join our study group, then we can discuss it more, yeah, about the coefficient of variation. SMS the ADI in here, yeah, about the average demand interval. I think how it works to avoid the bullwhip effect, you can use this diagram as well, yeah. That is my answer. Thank okay, you, Pak Fajar.
Yeah, that's my line, Pak. I'm just going to tell our friends and our professional here that we have a study group that have different topics each week. And then this week's topics is the VUCA in supply chain. So Pak Efrata will give explanation about the calculations needed and the techniques that can be used for these topics too. And so I see that some question, please friends and professionals, give your question here, because we still have another 5 minutes, and then after that you cannot ask anymore. So I really appreciate if you have some question around these topics, FUCA or any other kind of supply chains matter which regarding to this. In Indonesia, it's okay. You can put it there. That's it, I think.
I think that okay, is one question from Pak Suryo.
Okay, that's one question, Pak. Let me phrase it for you. How to make sure that we are responsive, fast enough to the market, Pak?
Responsive enough to the market. Yeah, thank you for the questions, Pak Suryo. And how to responsive enough to the market, it's mean we can adopt the one tools we can use is adopt the leadership FUCA in here, yeah. So vision, V for vision. So if we have a vision, it mean we can know that volatility will come, and then we know that something will happen. For example, if we talking about Fuji and then Kodak, yeah, you can see about the digital imaging and then the analog imaging. The vision, it's talking about the vision, yeah. If we want to be more responsive to the market, then we have to put the good vision, yeah. Which one is good, yeah? You see that previously Kodak is number one in the world, yeah, but now what happened with them, yeah? Because they don't have a vision about what will happen currently, yeah. And then the next is about the understanding, yeah. We can make the uncertainty become certain with our understanding. So this is a good tools to adopt. Then in the understanding means you will understand more about your team, and then you can understand more about the markets. So it will help us to prepare what will happen, and then we can more agile, yeah, to the market with the understanding, of course, yeah. And then the third is using clarity. So if we are facing a complexity, then we do the clarity. So with the clarity, we can have a SOP, yeah, standard operating procedures, and then we can have a clear programs. So what is our programs in the short terms, what is our programs in the long term. So it will help if we want to react more in the market. And then the last one is agility, yeah. With agile, so we will have a good communication, and then we will have a resilience, and then we can manage all of the things inside our company and along our supply chain. So I hope this can be a tools to help us to be more reactive with the demand in the market. Yeah, I think that is the answer from me, Pak.
Okay, Pak. Okay, the time is up, but I want to wrap this up first. So FUCA is not just one word, Pak. Yeah, it's not a vegetable stew. Okay. So FUCA is a matrix like BCG matrix or like many other metrics. So in any matrix, that's you have the tools for that matrix to how to implement or how to deal with that situation, depending on what matrix you are. So it's a really great explanation, Pak, for me, because I really previously I didn't know. So FUCA means that you're in the one of that situation, and how to deal with them is using the right tools for that matrix. Okay, thank you, Pak. I think that's where it wrap it up. And let me say it again that we have our channel, the Enabling Supply Chain. Thank you for joining us, and we have also a group for study group for professionals in Indonesia to learn together, to give and to participate and to get knowledge and skills and then we want to really expand our network and our understanding to the world of supply chains and many other things like strategy or finance or marketing or anything. You can join us by filling the form, the one that we already given to you, and then we can have a fun time together talking about our professionals do.
Okay,
thank you Pak Efrata for joining us today and giving us this sharing and presentation. It clears up a lot.
Yes, yeah, at least your understanding about vegetable and then the automotive industry of VUCA is already corrected, yeah?
Okay. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, Pak Christoph, okay. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Okay, close. Please ditutup, Pak. Oh, I'm, okay. Okay, thank you for today, friends and professionals. This is our closing remarks. I hope that you're having the same understanding, the same conclusion with me that VUCA is a matrix that can be used in solving our company's problem using the right tools. So, okay, see you in our next channel, our next webinar, our next free webinar, which is every Sunday at 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. in our channel Enabling Supply Chain Management. Follow us this channel and then follow our groups too. Thank you very much. Stay healthy and God bless you.